Hi guys, this is Liliana from Sugarella Sweets. Today I'll be showing you how to recreate both of these cakes. One made out of fondant and the other unicorn cake made out of buttercream. Let me know which one you liked best. Hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching. We'll add pre-sausage shapes using yellow golden fondant and then you're going to twist all of them together like so and simply roll it on your working surface. So that it becomes like one piece. What you want is for one end to be pointy and then the other one to be a little bit fatter. Simply cut off the ends, making sure everything is nice and neat, and then insert a skewer right in the middle. Transfer your coin onto a foam block and let it dry for at least 24 to 48 hours. Once your piece is completely dry, you can go ahead and then paint it with edible gold. Make sure that it is edible. And I always like to do two coats, so I do one coat, let it dry, and then do a second coat. It just gives a nice shiny effect to my unicorn. And by the way, all the material that I'll be using for this video will be in my description box. So for the ears, I'm using my peony cutters. I know this sounds bizarre, but you'll see where I'm going with this. So I'm going to cut off two pieces using the larger peony cutter, and then from that I'm going to cut off the top, which would be about a quarter of my piece, and I'm going to do the same thing with yellow fondant using the smaller cutter. Transfer your piece onto your foam pad and then create a crease using your ball tool. Using a small amount of water, glue both pieces together, and once again, you're going to create a little crease using your ball tool. Transfer your piece to your working surface and let it dry for at least 24 hours before painting it. Once your piece is completely dry, you can go ahead and then paint the yellow part using edible metallic gold. The reason why all my golden pieces are made out of yellow fondant is because you will have a better coverage once you paint it. But if you would have used white fondant, you would actually see the white fondant coming through your paint, and it just wouldn't give the same effect. Once you're done painting, transfer it to your working surface and let it dry. I baked three layers of a 6-inch cake that I stacked together, and right now I'm simply doing a crumb coat. I'm covering it with buttercream. Once that's covered, I'm going to chill it in the fridge for at least 15 minutes, bring it back, and then do a second coat. Cover your cake with white fondant. Start by the top by removing all the air bubbles and work your way on the sides, going all the way to the bottom, making sure everything is nice and smooth. And then you're going to do that really nice crisp edge using both of your smoothers, like so. And then when everything is nice and smooth, cut off the excess using your pizza cutter. Cut out two black pieces using your round cutter and then simply stretch out one end so that you get a pointy effect. Roll out white fondant and cut out two round large pieces using your plunger and glue them at the top of your eye. And then follow by two little pieces right at the bottom and two tiny little pieces right at the bottom of that one. Glue all of them together using a small amount of water. Transfer both eyes onto your cake and secure them using a small amount of water. And then finish the look of the eyes by simply gluing two little lashes on each side. Using a light shade of pink, you're going to glue two round pieces right at the bottom of your eye, and this will give the illusion of cheekbones. I prepared four different shades of buttercream and I'm going to transfer those onto a plastic wrap. The colors that you're going to choose don't really matter, but what you want for this cake is to have vibrant colors. So what I'm doing is I'm spreading the first color and then I'm going to do the second, the third, and the fourth as follows. Fold your saran wrap in half and then you're going to create a log like so, making sure that everything is nice and tight and that you're twisting both ends. And then using a pair of scissors, cut out one end, make sure to open the gap, and then transfer it to your piping bag, and then you're ready to pipe. You can use any piping tip that you want, but I like to use the 2D by Wilton. It just gives a really nice rosette. And then I simply start by the front, and then I work on my way to the back, and then on the side, and I simply press, swirl, and then release. Once you're satisfied with the look, place the corn and both ears on top of your head. Now I'm going to show you how to recreate the unicorn buttercream cake. We'll add pre-sausage shapes using yellow golden fondant and then you're going to twist all of them together like so and simply roll it on your working surface so that it becomes like one piece. What you want is for one end to be pointy and then the other one to be a little bit fatter. Simply cut off the ends, making sure everything is nice and neat, and then insert a skewer right in the middle. Transfer your corn onto a foam block and let it dry for at least 24 to 48 hours. Once your piece is completely dry, you can go ahead and then paint it with metallic edible gold and then set it aside so that your paint is completely dry. Following the same steps that you used for the other cake, cut out two pieces of white fondant with the large peony cutter. And then with that, you're going to cut out a fourth of that piece right at the top, like so. And then you're going to create the same process using a yellow fondant, but this time using the smaller cutter of the peony. Glue both pieces together using a small amount of water, transfer them onto your foam mat, and you're going to create a little crease using your ball tool. And then let them air dry for at least 24 hours. And then when everything is dry, you can go ahead and then paint it with edible metallic gold. Pull out yellow fondant and then using your round cutter, cut out two round shapes. And then cut at the inside using a smaller round cutter. Remove the fondant and then clean out the edges using your fingers, making sure everything is nice and crisp. Place both pieces one on top of the other and then cut them halfway. And then you're going to use a smaller round cutter and you're going to place that right in the middle of your piece just to make sure that you'll have the shape that you want, and you let it like that completely dry for at least 24 hours. Using the same color fondant, you're going to cut out three little pieces on each eye to create the lashes. So I'm going to first crumb coat my cake and put it in the fridge and chill it for at least 15 minutes. Take my cake out and then do a second coat of buttercream. This time I'm really going to make sure that I have a lot of buttercream on the sides so that I don't see my cake coming through. Once I'm done covering my cake, I can go ahead and place the eyes and the lashes. Paint your eyes using edible metallic gold using a small little brush. I prepared four different shades of buttercream and I'm going to transfer those onto a plastic wrap. The colors that you're going to choose don't really matter, but what you want for this cake is to have vibrant colors. So what I'm doing is I'm spreading the first color and then I'm going to do the second, the third, and the fourth as follows. Fold your saran wrap in half and then you're going to create a log like so, making sure that everything is nice and tight and that you're twisting both ends. And then using a pair of scissors, cut out one end, make sure to open the gap, and then transfer it to your piping bag, and then you're ready to pipe. Always start piping your cake from the front, work your way towards the back, and then end up finishing your details on the side. Once you did your piping on top of your cake, you can go ahead and place your corn and also both of your ears. To finish the look of the cake, simply do rosettes on the side, and this is it. Let me know in the comments which one you like best. Is it the unicorn fondant cake or the buttercream unicorn cake? I really hope you enjoyed the video and thanks again for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you want more videos like this, simply subscribe to my channel for free.